Now, I think I've pinpointed for the insulation with a little black mark what we were began to aim for. Oh no, it's there. No, not code level 3, so we turn over the page and we went to level 4. Now, the point I'm making is that once you've got a package, and that's what the code gives you, is a package of measures, and then you say, oh, our walls need to be 0.25, or our walls need to be 0.25 again if we go to level 4. Oh, that's easy. So it's working through and finding out the level that you think you could go for, either in the roof or the walls or wherever else. On the side, you'll also see another panel marked ventilation on the same set under level 3 or level 4. If you look towards your right, you'll see a panel marked ventilation. And we'll come back to the ventilation level in a moment. What we did is we stumbled towards that, but what we did is we got a spec drawn up by an architectural technician, and then we got a issue to grapple with was about air tightness and ventilation, which again we'll touch on. The idea is to make it airtight, to eliminate drafts, and to reduce heat loss. We learned that air tightness or lack of it can lose you as much as 7 or even up to 20%, depending on the house, of your energy. But drafts, there's an added reason why you attend to that. If there were drafts, what would you do? Nobody would do anything. Come on, folks, what would you do?
Turn up the thermostat.
Thank you. Right, and here's a picture which we posed for yesterday of a thermostat and somebody pressing it to turn it up. Okay. So the solution is to get to grips and understand ventilation and heat extraction. Sorry, and air inflow. That's the thing together. I'm not going to say more than that, but there is an understanding of it, and you can use the heat of the outgoing air to heat the incoming air. But we didn't understand this until towards the end, and therefore, what did we do? We were faced with taking up floorboards and everything again. So the core thing is to put in, to think about what you're going to do, and if you think you're going to have moist air extractor and draw in cold air for ventilation, then think about it at the beginning. And there are issues about how you measure that. Where the drafts come, an amazing number of places. And again, look that up. We got a man with a gun. A smoking gun, no less. But I've discovered somebody, they may be here today, I can't remember, just uses a candle. And you go to the places where there are drafts, and if the candle wavers or joysticks will work, and it'll show you where your drafts are. So you don't have to get one of these. But basically, he went around and he found drafts in all sorts of places. Now we go back to that one. Because what surprised the architect and everybody else was the draft, you can't see it here, between the edge of the wall and the floor, which was a big draft, and that's on a solid floor. So I'm going to skip and just say that's a heat exchanger, folks, and it simply shows you hot air going out and changing heating gently the heat coming, the air coming in. So you reduce your fuel bill that way. In fact, it works out about even. But when people say you're doing this for comfort, it's really comfort and therefore being able to turn your thermostat down. The next thing to understand, and then I think I'll stop because we've got 15 minutes each, is U values. Anybody know what a U value is? 1, 2, 3, 4, excellent, 5, 6, here we go. Therefore, I think it is the rate at which the heat is lost through a material, such as through brick, glass, wood, aluminium, or insulation materials. Would you agree? Yes-ish. Excellent. I know I'm talking with now with a room that's got a lot more expertise in it than I've got. So, Oswald, go carefully. If you've got a greenhouse or ordinary glass one pane, that's got a room value of 5.5. In other words, the heat can go out through it quite easily. If, on the other hand, you've got double glazing, standard, it will go out, heat will be lost more slowly, so that's 2.7. If you've got super double glazing with low emissivity and argon, you can see it could be as low as 1.3. If you get a triple glazing for your Velux, and Velux do them as a standard, you'll get it down to a U value of 1. If you get triple glazing from a super duper person, you can get it down to 0.87. Insulation such as this can help you get it down to 0.23, 0.22. Okay? So it's useful to understand that. We didn't understand it for ages. Heating controls, gonna belt through that. We had ours where we thought you could see them, and then we put a cupboard over it. And the consequence is that the cupboard doors, that's fine, we can open them, but there's a lot of things there. And Mary said to me, what are you doing a slide about wine of chili from? Which is what it says there, but you can't see. Put your controls, if you can see this bit, in your face. Okay, or windows. In a nutshell, if we were going to have super duper insulated walls, did we want to let it all out through the super big windows at the back? Answer no. So, it was really hard to find out about windows. Long journey. The answer is, discover and understand windows for your U values, then find somebody who will supply windows at 0.87, and that person is Colin of Hallwood Joinery. Not in Poland, not up in Huddersfield Road, just along the road in Cajun. And he's a star. There he is, fitting the windows. Oh, this is slow. So there he is, big, heavy things. And that was the end result. So we make best use of the sun. There we are. Costs. In all, we probably spent about £100,000. But remember, what we were doing was the roof, a room in the roof, which is standard price, about £25,000 to £30,000. We were doing extension at back, standard price about £15,000 to £20,000. All in, we spent probably about £100,000. Revaluation, wait for it, £80,000 to £100,000. And estimated annual return by a professor of economics, welfare economics, and he said, you'll get about 12% return on this. So which was the better?